Hi, my name is Dennis Whitney. I'm Senior Vice President of the Institute of Certified Management Accountants. And I'm here today to talk to you about upcoming changes to the CMA program. Before I get into what's changing and why we're changing, I want to make sure that you know these changes are not happening until January of 2020. So if you're currently studying for the CMA exam, don't worry, just continue to focus on your current material and work toward finishing the program this year. ICMA is dedicated to ensuring the relevance of the CMA program and maintaining the CMA as the preeminent management accounting certification in the world. As many of you know, the profession is changing. Artificial intelligence, robotic process automation, and blockchain are changing how accountants work and demanding new skills of management accountants. ICMA is dedicated to ensuring that you have the skills that are needed today and in the future. So the main reason we're changing is relevance. We want to ensure the relevance of the CMA. And how do we do that? Every 4 to 5 years, ICMA does what we call a job analysis study. We survey management accountants throughout the world. We ask them, what are they doing on the job? And what skills do they need to do their job effectively and efficiently? Based on the results of that research study, we make changes to the content specification outline of the CMA. So we did this survey last year. We began early in 2018. And based on the results of that survey, we decided to make changes to the CMA. First of all, the CMA is going to remain a two-part exam with 100 multiple choice questions and 2 essay sections. The biggest change will be in part one. In part one, we're adding a new section, a new content area called technology and analytics. This is the content that we found in the job analysis survey that the CMA needed more than any other content. So what exactly is this new content? First of all, this section of the exam will be divided into 4 different subcategories: information systems, data governance, technology-enabled finance transformation, and data analytics. So in the first section, information systems, we're talking about accounting information systems, enterprise resource planning systems, and performance management systems. In the second section, data governance, that's focused on ensuring the integrity, reliability, and security of the data. The third section on technology enablement is focused on some of the newer technologies, for example, blockchain. And then finally, data analytics, which will be the main focus of this section. We'll be testing concepts such as data mining, data analytics, including descriptive and predictive analytics, and also visualizing data. After you've analyzed the data, how do you visualize and communicate the results? So that'll be 15% of part one, a new content area on part one. Because of that change, we've had to adjust the percentages of some of the other content areas, and made some other minor changes. The new title for part one will be Financial Planning, Performance, and Analytics. The other part that's going to change is part two, not so significantly, but there are changes in part two as well. Ethics will be increased, will be have more emphasis on ethics. We'll be adding a subsection on business analytics, which covers, for example, moral philosophies and ethical business decision making. And then we will also be increasing our emphasis on decision analysis on part two, in line with the analytics focus. The new title for part two will be Strategic Management, Strategic Financial Management. Okay, so it's remains a two-part exam with the same format, but more focus on analytics, which is the skill set that will be needed in the future. So again, the emphasis is on relevance, maintaining the ICMA as the premier management accounting credential in the world. So some questions you might have is, well, what if I don't finish the program before the end of this year and the new exam comes into effect in January 2020? Do I get to continue with the old program? And if not, do I lose credit for an exam part? Well, the answer is no, you can't continue with the current program. You'd have to go into the new program. However, any part that you passed prior to 2020 will be recognized. So you don't have to worry about that. If you passed part one this year, you didn't pass part two by the end of the year, you still get to keep credit for part one. You just need to finish part two under the new program. So the last testing window for the current exam will be September and October for the English exam, and then November for the Chinese language exam. And the first testing window for the new program will be January, February 2020, and then April 2020 for the Chinese language exam. Another question you might have is study material. All the review course providers who publish books have the new content specification outlines and the learning outcome statements and have been working for a number of months on preparing the new material. So I suggest you contact them directly for the details on that. Another thing to keep in mind is that developing these skills are critically important. You should not be overwhelmed by these changes. It's a manageable amount of material, and they're really going to set you up for the future, giving you the skills that you need to be successful in your career, advancing your career, and driving business performance. The CMA exam has been a model of integrity and relevance for over 45 years now. We have over 65,000 CMAs that we've awarded since 1972. We have over 64,000 people right now currently enrolled in the program. We're growing every year worldwide, and this change will be just another change that we make to ensure the integrity of the CMA program. I encourage you to look at the article in the January Strategic Finance magazine, which details these changes. This is an article Paul Juris, who is the chair of the Board of Regents, wrote, and myself. And if you have any questions after reading that article, please feel free to email me at dwhitney@imanet.org. I wish you the best of luck finishing the CMA. And I'm very excited about this new change. I think it's great for the CMA program and all CMAs and CMA candidates around the world. So thank you, and see you again in the future.